Healthy Weight Loss Without Dieting, Healthiest Way of Eating Approach. Author, George Mateljan, founder of Health Valley Foods, author of the best-selling The World's Healthiest Foods, Essential Guide for the Healthiest Way of Eating. Chapter 4. World's Healthiest Foods Help You Manage Adverse Food Reactions. Reaction. You almost always feel better if you can eliminate the food from your meal plan, or at least substantially cut back on your consumption of the food. As you will see later in this chapter, this process of avoiding potentially troublesome foods usually falls under the heading of an elimination diet. Later in this chapter, I'll be telling you much more about the details of a modified elimination diet that you can follow in your own meal planning as you pursue weight loss and more vibrant health. Adverse food reactions really boil down to a kind of mismatch between a person and a food. You and I may just not be cut out to eat anything and everything. If you and your food are mismatched, you may have a more difficult time losing weight. Recent reviews of popular weight loss diets clearly show that unusual diets mismatch not only to a person's nutrient needs, but also to a person's broader metabolic pattern are unsupportive of weight loss in comparison to balanced, metabolically matched diets. Although adverse food reactions have not been specifically studied in this regard, they are established as real-life responses to food that can upset many different metabolic balances in a person's body and can compromise function in several different body systems, including the digestive system, immune system, nervous system, endocrine system, and inflammatory system. If these body systems are not working well, your path to healthy and optimal weight loss will be compromised. Two important examples of adverse food reactions not specifically linked to weight management problems, but relatively high up on most research lists of foods most likely to cause adverse reactions are dairy and wheat. Here's a closer look at each of those foods and their potential for adverse reactions. In the case of dairy, as many as 15% of US infants show unwanted reactions to cow's milk, including common symptoms that can be related to many other factors besides food. These symptoms include irritableness, fussiness, upset stomach, and bowel problems like excessive gas, bloating, or diarrhea when tested for food allergy. However, as few as 5% of all infants actually test positive for cow's milk allergy. The frequency of dairy allergy in adults has been estimated in some studies to be similar to the frequency in children, and in other studies to be somewhat lower. As is the case for all food allergies, we do not have very accurate data to estimate the number of people actually affected. In the case of dairy, sometimes the adverse reaction is related to milk sugar, lactose. Not all individuals have enough of the enzyme lactase to break down milk sugar and allow it to digest properly. Unfortunately, in the processed food world, milk sugar, lactose, is often added to non-dairy foods for flavor, and the only way to avoid it is to read the ingredient list on the package. Sliced deli meats, powdered coffee creamers, and ready-to-eat baked goods are examples of foods that can contain lactose. Many individuals also have allergic reactions to special proteins in cow's milk called caseins. Unfortunately, in the processed food world, these proteins are also frequently found in a wide variety of foods in forms like calcium caseinate or sodium caseinate. Hot dogs, deli meats, nutrition bars, and protein powder drinks are examples of foods that can contain casein. Individuals who experience adverse reactions to dairy often feel like their entirely dietary balance is affected. The consequences of consuming dairy can detract too much from the satisfaction of eating, or lead to confusion about the trustworthiness of the diet. Under these circumstances, the challenges of weight management often become more difficult. In the case of wheat, there is even less conclusive research on adverse food reactions than there is for dairy. But scientists continue to investigate links between specific wheat proteins, including gliadin proteins and lectins, especially WGA, or wheat germ agglutinin, and their ability to cause adverse reactions. Much like the situation for lactose and casein in dairy, wheat components find their way into many types of processed foods, and it is possible to experience an adverse reaction to wheat, even if you do not eat foods like wheat. World's Healthiest Foods Help You Manage Adverse Food Reactions. Bread and wheat pasta that are clearly recognizable as wheat-containing foods. The list of processed foods that can contain wheat components includes soy sauce, teriyaki sauce, and seasoning mixes. Common processed food ingredients like malt, including barley malt and malt extract, may also contain components of wheat. Like adverse reactions to dairy. Adverse reactions to wheat can leave individuals feeling like their entire dietary balance is thrown off, and can increase the difficulty of weight management. Elimination diet. I have seen that adverse food reactions can be a barrier to losing weight. As such, when you embark on your healthy weight loss, if you find that after 3 weeks of focusing your diet on enjoying the world's healthiest foods you don't lose any weight, you may want to investigate whether adverse food reactions may be the culprit. What I would recommend in this situation is a modified elimination diet. One of the best tools to use for this is to keep a journal. Write down all the foods that eat each meal, and then when you reintroduce eliminated foods, write down whether or not you notice experiencing an adverse reaction to them. I realize that you'll need the help of a licensed healthcare practitioner to diagnose or treat a food allergy, and that you will also need the support of a healthcare practitioner to go on a full-fledged, nutritionally restrictive or nutritionally complicated elimination diet. I should also point out here that in the case of some full-blown elimination diets, medical monitoring is important from a safety standpoint. But I'm not talking about a full-blown elimination diet in this situation. I'm only talking about some practical steps you can take to experiment with avoidance of foods that are most commonly associated with adverse food reactions. The chart below shows the foods that are less likely to be associated with these kinds of problematic reactions. You'll have to decide how comfortable you are restricting your food intake to the above list. If you are worried about staying well nourished, cabbage, carrots, celery, collard greens, garlic, green beans, green peas, kale, olive oil, onions, lettuce, sea vegetables, summer squash, zucchini, sweet potatoes, Swiss chard, winter squash, apples, grapes, lemons, pears, brown rice, black beans, garbanzo beans, lentils, pumpkin seeds, sesame seeds, sunflower seeds, cod, salmon, lamb. World's healthiest foods help you manage adverse food reactions. On the above foods, you should consult with a healthcare practitioner, rather than attempting these dietary changes on your own. You aren't likely to see many changes in your health or well-being, unless you stick with these food modifications for at least 1 week, so you need to feel comfortable in sticking to this restricted meal plan for that amount of time. At the end of 1 week, you will want to start reintroducing old foods back into your meal plan. I recommend that you introduce only one food at a time, and that you wait at least 2 days before reintroducing another food. I would also recommend that you start with asparagus, avocados, beets, broccoli, Brussels sprouts, cauliflower, cucumbers, blueberries, watermelon, flax seeds, and quinoa when starting this food reintroduction process, since they are not as commonly associated with adverse food reactions as some of the other foods you might have eliminated from your meal plan. After that, you will want to continue reintroducing other foods back into your meal plan, on this same one per day basis, and waiting at least 2 days, before you add the next food. While you are reintroducing the foods that you avoided during your week on the modified elimination diet, try to notice any adverse reactions that you may have. Try to pay special attention to any problems that prompted you to experiment with food elimination in the first place. If these problems return, it might be evidence that the newly reintroduced food is not well matched for your body's metabolism and might be worth avoiding in future meal planning. If you do suspect any adverse reactions using this modified elimination approach, you should definitely consider a consultation with a nutritionist or other healthcare provider who has extensive experience with food allergy. A more structured elimination challenge diet might also be important to consider. For more information on food allergy and sensitivity, the World's Healthiest Foods book. We all want extra energy usually at all times, but especially when we think about losing weight. It's common to experience a depletion of energy when we change our food intake patterns or cut back on our overall caloric intake. At these times, it's more important than ever for our food to give us that extra energy boost. This is one reason why nutrient-rich world's healthiest foods are so beneficial. They help you feel energized while shedding pounds. And it's quite simple how it happens. The world's healthiest foods can help energize you by providing your body with ample amounts of nutrients required by the body's energy production systems. It's not just that they provide you with enough macronutrients, carbohydrates, protein, fat, that serve as a starting place for the production of energy. They also contain micronutrients vitamins and minerals that help to release the energy and then recapture it so it can be stored for later use when and where it's most needed. Capturing energy from the food you eat takes place in your cells. Some of the most important energy production spots are very small microstructures inside our cells called mitochondria. The energy production process that takes place in our mitochondria is a complicated process. To function properly, it involves a variety of enzymes that require many vital health promoting nutrients such as vitamins B1, B2, B3, B5, and B6, lipoic acid, coenzyme Q, as well as iron, magnesium, and sulfur. So, imagine the difference in how much energy you'll feel from eating nutrient-poor refined foods as opposed to nutrient-rich whole foods such as fresh fruits. If you enjoyed this audiobook and want to hear again, be sure to click that subscribe button and click also the notification bell to switch between getting all notifications, and like and share, leave your comment and suggestion below. Thanks for watching.